What's up, guys? I thought I'd make a little video about the Pirate Rumble teams that are currently used and the teams that you could use right now, actually. There are many, many teams and many variations, and yeah, you can lose the overview about all of this, and so maybe it's good to have a little collection of all the teams that there are, essentially. I know there are some variations that I didn't count in now because, yeah, essentially there are so many characters, you can build thousands of different teams, but I just put the teams in their basic form and, yeah, you can go from there. And if there is something that you can take into consideration or options that you have, I will talk about them. So let's start here. The first team, and I called them the Speed Slashers, are the normal slasher team with Roger, Odenlaw, Doofy and Kizaru. In my opinion, still the strongest team overall in Pirate Rumble. Very quick, very strong. They deal a massive amount of damage, and of course they deal a lot of fixed damage, and so yeah, all the teams that have high def up and not have that much HP will still not win against this team, which make them so strong. And yeah, this is a really, really good team. So yeah, I like this team a lot. For substitutions, you could think about substituting almost every character except for Roger, Odin and Doofy, I would say. If you don't have any of those three, don't build this team. It's very important that you keep the basis of this team together, just because that's what makes the team so good. So yeah, if you're missing like Law, then you can just put in maybe the Halloween Law, or yeah, essentially another slasher unit, maybe even Carrot, because Carrot also deals fixed damage, and yeah, that shouldn't make that much of a difference, so just put in Carrot then. For the bench, play Kaku and not Whitebeard, just because in this speed team you want to kill your opponent quickly, and if something goes wrong, Kaku benefits from the slasher buffs. That means he is most likely ready to go when he comes in, or he will be faster ready to go. And with PvP Whitebeard, it's a bit of a gamble because sometimes he's ready, sometimes he's not, and Kaku benefits from the buffs of the team and PvP Whitebeard does not, but it doesn't make that much of a difference. Third option here for the bench would be Kagura and Noland, but they are significantly worse just because they only hit a single character and they are way better when played on the main team. Okay, that's about it for the Speed Slasher team. Now for the second team here, I have the 8 Speed Slasher team. This is essentially the same team, just you take out the Law, and for that Law you add 4 Pirate Rumble characters. And you would think that this team automatically is better than the other team, right? No, they are not. This team is, I would say, a bit worse, and that just comes down to the fact that just by removing that one Law, you lose speed of your team that you need to win in some of the games. For example, if you play against another slasher team that has Roger and Odin, and they have that Law, more of the time they will win because their specials will come through sooner and yours will come through later. So yeah, this is still a very, very good team, and in my opinion maybe the one of the top 5 teams. I won't say second or third best, because there's just so much RNG in Pirate Rumble that you really, really can't say a team is second place, third place, fourth place. I would just say here in this video, these teams that I picked are all top 20, I would say. And yeah, this team is top 5, definitely. Very, very strong, but not as strong as the normal team. And for substitutions here, it's the same. If you don't have Kizaru or something like that, just add Carrot or add another slasher that deals damage. And for the Pirate Rumble characters, if you don't have Sanji, Sanji essentially is my fourth unit here, because this team tries to kill your opponent quickly. and Sanji does a lot of damage like all of the other Pirate Rumble characters in this team. So if you would have a replacement for Sanji, don't pick Otama in this team because she doesn't do anything. Then play with Josu or play with Stussy, or yeah, that should be the substitutions for damage. Okay, then let's move on to the next team. My next team that I have here is the Hybrid Slasher team. This is the team that I used last season. I don't think this is the best team, and that's not why I used it, just because I wanted to test out the Halloween Legends, and essentially you can play any of these 12 teams that I present to you in this video. You just have to know what kind of opponents you can attack. That is a general thing in Pirate Rumble. If you don't plan on going top 10 or top 100 in the championship, essentially you can build almost any team. You just have to nitpick your opponents, right? And that's the same with this team. Don't attack the Speed Slasher team with this team, because more often than less, they will run you over because that team has just better special charge. They are quicker than your team. Sometimes if you're lucky, your law will come in sooner than their own, and then you will win, but that doesn't happen so often. But this team is very, very good against all other teams that try to stall you out, that try to bring you in the mid game with high death characters, high HP whatsoever, just because if this team doesn't die soon, it will kill your opponent definitely. Just because look at the damage. At some point of the game, your opposing team will be special binded by Law, action binded by Shanks, and then blown out of the world by Roger, Odin and Doffy. And yeah, Shanks and Law also do damage. And if everything goes wrong, you still have Whitebeard from the bench to finish the job, right? So yeah, it's a very fun team and I loved using it last season. You can see it on my channel. I have some videos from this team, and yeah, it's quite amazing. And remember guys, if you play such a team that has the 5 legend lineup, I would call it, always remember that after putting in your Pirate Rumble character, you still have cost left over. You have 5 team cost left over. Fill that in with 1 cost units. I haven't listed them here because in Tier List Maker they are not accessible. But put in 2 1 cost units in the team. And if you really, really try to play serious in PvP, give them cotton candy as well. Just because they can take a hit that can be a decisive factor in a match. If they come in from the bench, even these 1 cost unit, and they get attacked instead of your Odin, and then Odin can use a special, you might win the game, right? So always fill up your bench with all the units. Don't leave empty spaces. Okay, yeah, let's move on to the next team. We are still in the slasher team variations because there's just so much you can build. This is another team that you can build. It's a rainbow slasher team. It's still named slasher because yeah, there are more slasher here than other characters, but yeah, it's essentially a rainbow team. It's also a very good team that focuses on killing your opponent in the mid game and not the early game, and surviving for the other part of the match, because you see there's Shanks crew, there's V2 Rayleigh that are high death characters, and there's also high DPS characters with PvP Whitebeard, with Roger and with Odin. So yeah, you won't kill your opponent quickly in this team, but you will dominate the mid game if you get there. And then of course, because it's a team with 4 legends, you can play 4 Pirate Rumble characters. So if you have 4 Pirate Rumble characters, put them all in. These 4 here, Whitebeard, Kaku, Kagara, Nol and Otama, are the optimal ones I think for this team. Sometimes it's better to put in Josu than one of the other characters, but if your team doesn't have a single int unit, don't put in Josu. Josu benefits from teams that already have int characters in them. Okay, let's move on. The next team I have for you is the old school slasher. If you can play any of the other teams, I wouldn't recommend building this team. I mean any of the other slasher teams, just because this team is weaker. It's definitely weaker, but you can still beat a lot of teams with this team. Don't get me wrong, right? This is the old school slasher team that was dominant on Japan for many months, and yeah, because of Roger and Oden, it has not seen play, because many people have Roger and Oden or one of the two. But you can still build this team. It focuses on having a high death with Shanks Crew and Dofi, and then killing your opponents quickly after the Raid Mihawk has HP cutted your opponent. Dofi and Carrot try to finish the job together with Kizaru, who has a lot of specials. So yeah, his special CT is very low, so maybe you will use the special like 3 times in one match. And yeah, the thing is, this Raid Mihawk has low HP, and what will happen in most of the games is he will get his special through and then he will die, and then PvP Whitebeard comes from the bench in the end game, and then this team can finish the job, right? But the problem is, nowadays there will be no end game. If you play this team into the normal speed slasher team, you will just lose. You will just be obliterated after 30 seconds. You have no chance of winning. So if you have the other units, build that team. Like I said before, you always have to know what your team's capabilities are. And it's no problem if you don't, if you're a free-to-play player, for example, and you don't invest much money into the game and you're missing all of the newer units just because you're saving up for Kaido and Big Mom, that's really, really no problem. Then, yeah, by any means, play this team, but don't attack any of the teams that I show to you in this video. You just have to pick weak dev teams. That's all. And yeah, if you are free to play, you're obviously not pushing for the top, also in Pirate Rumble. And so you shouldn't be having any problems finding opponents that you can beat, right? Okay, good. Then I don't need to explain anything here. I think, yeah, for the substitute characters that you can use here, obviously all the other slashers, Cracker, Inuarashi, yeah, you have replacements en masse. Next team. First time no slasher team, it's the Int team. The Int team is also very strong, and it's gotten way stronger since we've gotten the Halloween Legends. The only problem for the Int team is that Roger and Oden exist, and yeah, that brings them into a hard position. This team is very strong. It has the same problem that the hybrid slasher team with Mihawk and Lawhead, not Mihawk, with Shanks and Lawhead, that if your Law is quicker than your opponent's Oden, you will win, but most of the time he isn't, and then you will lose. So yeah, still, this is a very strong team and you can still beat the slasher team with it, but more often than not you're not going to. And yeah, it focuses on using the high def and high HP of Jozo and Enel, staying alive, don't losing a single unit, and then finishing the job with Katakuri, with Law, with Shanks. And yeah, remember, you have team cost left over in this team as well, but don't fill it up, because Enel just gets his ability when your team is 6 or less. So if you put 8 units on your team and bench, he will not get his effect. So don't do that. Next team. Int variation. It's essentially the same team, just without the Halloween Legends. So this is the team that was used before and was dominant on Global and Pirate Rumble for many months. Still a very, very strong team. PvP Whitebeard from the bench to finish the job. And yeah, then it's the same. It's high def team, which still deals a lot of damage, has a lot of sustain, and yeah, it's still very strong to this day. For the next team, that is the normal Rainbow team. This team was played heavily on Japan as well, but you have to keep in mind that at the point in the meta on Japan where we are right now, Japan obviously didn't have Roger and Oden, and I switched out the Tesoro that was on this team originally and put Roger in, just because that gives this team a boost. So yeah, if you don't have Roger, put in Tesoro, and then you essentially have the same team that Japan had. But yeah, always remember it was a different meta then. This team obviously is also a high def team. It has V2 Rayleigh and Shanxcrew for the def, so it has a lot of sustain. And then you have Roger and Luffy, Sanji and PvP Whitebeard for the damage. So this is also a team that is very balanced and tries to win mid game to end game. So if you can manage to survive versus the speed slashers, then this team will probably win. But like with the other teams, if you're playing against the perfect speed slasher team with full cotton candy and fully maxed out units, I think you will just be obliterated. And yeah, that's the problem that many teams have here, but that cannot be the standard for this video, right? Because obviously if you have the unit, just play the speed slasher team or any other of the Roger Oden variants until they get nerfed or we get better units to work against them. Like Japan, they got the PvP Ana right now, a unit which debuffs slashers, and yeah, we are missing those units obviously at the moment, so the meta is not that diverse. But still, with this team you can beat many other teams. Just don't challenge the teams that you obviously cannot beat and you're fine, right? Yeah. And for the bench units, obviously another team that has one Pirate Rumble unit in the main lineup, meaning only four legends, and that always leads to you having all the 8 spots open for Pirate Rumble characters, so fill it in with all of them that you have. For this team in particular, I've used this Cat Viper here this time, Nekomamushi, just because he is also a high def unit. We have a healer here and we have Kagara and Nolan for a bit of damage. Obviously, if you don't have this unit, just put in another unit. It doesn't make that much of a difference. Okay, let's continue. The next team, the Psy team. Essentially a team for people who have Boa and Roger and are missing Oden. That's just how it is. Because I think this team is better than the old school slashers, and I think it's also better than the Int team. Because this team debuffs Int with Law and with Aokiji. You should win normally if your units are maxed out. And yeah, it's a strong team. Focuses on the Psy type, and it's a very, very balanced team. It's not quick. It's a balanced team that has a lot of fixed damage. Boa targets the lowest HP enemy and essentially then just kills them. So yeah, you could be lucky, you could be unlucky. That's an RNG unit here. And yeah, you know what Kizaru does, you know what Roger does. Aokiji, like I said, debuffs Int, gives a bit of death up. Debuffs strength as well, so yeah, he debuffs Oden, but doesn't make that much of a difference. And then of course you have PvP Whitebeard from the bench, and again, put in 2 1 cost units, because that is a team with 5 legends, which means you have 5 cost left over. Okay, let's go on with the next team. The next team is the Quick Striker team, which was played a lot actually on Japan, but they didn't have Roger and Oden, like I said. It's a team focuses on surviving long enough, because yeah, it also has good defensive characters with V2 Rayleigh and with Cat Viper, and also fixed damage with Tesoro, speed and damage with Stussy, and action bind with these Aokiji. And then from the bench, because this is a team that plays essentially 2 Pirate Rumble characters in the main lineup, you have the option of bringing a legend from the bench. So pick a legend that you want for this team. It doesn't have to be a striker, it can also be a quick character, and Carrot is very good for late game because she has a lot of damage, a lot of fixed damage. The same with PvP Whitebeard, and yeah, the same with Kagara and Nolan. They are all 3 of them are good damage dealers to come in late when the enemy's team is softened by your main lineup. And personally, if I see this team, I wouldn't even attack it with my Speed Slasher team, just because I would be too scared to lose to RNG by this Aokiji action binding my whole team. So yeah, this team is a bit RNG based, but if you really have no other units, it can work as well. And yeah, like I said, you will always find teams that you can beat if you're not trying to challenge the top. Okay, let's go on. Next team, the old school shooter team. Still, I would say a good team. It essentially leans on the same that the team before this, and that is this Aokiji essentially action biting your whole opponent team. Because if that happens and all of the other specials go through, you're still just winning against every other team here, right? But obviously, this is very RNG based, and this team has not that much death. So if that not happens, it will probably get obliterated by 90% of the other teams here. And yeah, it's still strong though, and against certain opponents it will still work really, really well. If your opponent, for example, plays a high healing team, you could also think about swapping Lucci out for the V3 Akainu, who essentially one-shots healers. And then you have a good heal killer team, for example. But I wouldn't recommend investing in this team too much, because you should be able to build any of the other teams, right? But yeah, you can build it. Next team, and maybe even the last team, I'm not really sure. But it's the last team. The last team of this video is the fighter team. And the fighter team, with the new edition of Luffy Sanji, is really good. It's a high HP, high def team with healing. So yeah, this team doesn't kill your opponent quickly, but it withers him down quite a bit, just because Jack has an HP cut, this Jinbei has high def, Otama has healing, and then obviously Luffy Sanji and PvP Whitebeard are both insane damage dealers. So if they survive, or if this team survives until they use their special, you essentially win, because it's such so much damage. And yeah, if someone dies here, you still have a strong bench. And remember, this is also a team that has two Pirate Rumble characters in the main team, which means you can bring a legend from the bench. And since Katakuri is a fighter, bring him from the bench. He's perfect in late game, perfect. He has a lot of fixed damage, and yeah, Kaku and Kagano Nolan obviously are very good damage dealers as well. So let me go back to the start for a second. So just that I can give you my opinion on how strong these teams are on a scale, so that you get an idea what you should build. I'm not going to say this is the third best team, this is the sixth best team. That is just stupid, I think, because you cannot say that. There are so many matchups that you cannot say. You can say what team is the best team if everyone uses this and this has a high win rate, but not for like 20 teams. That's just not right, right? So yeah, if I would go from scale from 1 to 10, I would say 10 out of 10, 9 out of 10, 9 out of 10, this team probably 9 out of 10 as well, this team maybe 6 out of 10, 9 out of 10, 8.5 out of 10, also 8.5, 8 out of 10, 8 out of 10, yeah, 7 out of 10 maybe, 6 to 7 out of 10. And this fighter team, I cannot really rate that because I haven't played it myself for enough, but I think also around 8 to 9 out of 10. So yeah, these teams are, some are old, and that's why they fell down, but the other ones are all very close. And yeah, you saw how hard it was for me to rate these teams. I can just say that this is the best team. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and yeah, I think we collected very many of the most recent teams. And yeah, don't forget guys, there's still hundreds of teams more where just two or three units are flipped out, which are essentially all rainbow variants of rainbow teams, which can work against different teams, and that's what makes the fun in Pirate Rumble, I think. Having this variations of teams, and yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and have a nice day.